In this session, we are going to see about the governing equations. The governing equations is based on the conservation law of physics. This is by three ways. That is conservation of mass, Newton's second law, that is the change of momentum equals the sum of forces on a fluid particle. Next, first law of thermodynamics, that is the rate of change of energy equals the sum of rate of heat addition to and work done on fluid particle. Here the entire fluid is treated as a continuum. Next slide, Lagrangian versus Eulerian descriptions. In Lagrangian, a fluid flow field can be thought as a being comprised of a large number of finite sized fluid particles in which we have mass, momentum, internal energy and other properties. Here mathematically these laws can be written for each fluid particle. That is what is seen in a diagram. Next, for Eulerian description. In the Eulerian description of fluid motion, we consider how flow properties change at a fluid element which is fixed in space and time. In other words, it's a function of space and time. That is x, y, z, t, rather than the following individual fluid particles. Next, we are going to study about the fluid element and its properties. The behavior of fluid or the macroscopic properties are termed as velocities, pressure, density, temperature and energy. Velocity is represented as u and pressure as p, density as rho, temperature as t and energy as e. Here the properties are averages of a sufficiently larger number of molecules. As I told you before, it is treated as in a continuum medium and here the assumption is valid. The properties at phases, here you can able to see the small fluid element, it is represented in a cube. There some of the notations are given, like the phases are mentioned as N, E, W, S, like north, south, east and west phases. And top and bottom are represented as T phase and B phase. The distances, smaller distances are marked as through x direction is del x, for y is del y and for z is del z. For west phase and east phase, our expression will be termed in terms of Taylor series expansion as for Pw, which is equal to P minus dou P by dou x into 1 by 2 del x. And for Pe, which is equal to Pe plus dou P by dou x 1 by 2 into del x. The plus and minus represent as inflow and outflow. Next, we are going to solve for mass balance. Here, the rate of increase of mass in fluid elements equals to net rate of flow of mass into element. The rate of increase is given as dou by dou t rho into del x del y del z. Combinedly, you can write as dou p by dou t into del x del y del z. As I told you before, the positive and negative are represented as inflows and outflows of a fluid. Here in this fluid element, the expressions are given for each phases and for the expressions are termed in a positive and negative as the fluid enters and fluid goes out. So summing up all the equations for x, y, z, you will be getting the total mass equation. That is what written in this next slide, that is in continuity equation. Summing up all the terms and dividing by the whole volume, that is whole volume is del x, del y, del z. So you will be getting this equation, dou p by dou t plus dou rho u by dou x plus dou rho v by dou y plus dou rho w by dou z is equal to 0. In other words, like we can mention this as in a vector notation, like dou rho by dou t plus dou rho u, which is equal to 0. This dou u means dou u by dou x, dou v by dou y and dou w by dou z. That is what mentioned as dou u. This is represented in a vector notation. For incompressible fluid, we will be keeping dou rho by dou t as 0 so that your equation becomes as dou u, which is equal to 0. That is what it is mentioned, and that dou u also can be expanded in a longhand notation as dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y plus dou w by dou z, which is equal to 0. Next, we are going to study about the different forms of the continuity equation. Here some of different forms are given. First one is the integral form for conservation. That is dou by dou t, triple integral with respect to volume, rho dv, plus double integral with respect to surface, rho u ds is equal to 0. This is for finite control volume fixed in space. Next, integral form for non-conservation form. The expression is given as d by dt, triple integral with respect to volume, rho dv, which is equal to 0. This equation is applicable for finite control volume fixed mass moving with a flow. Next comes the differential for conservation form. Here in this, dou rho by dou t plus del into rho u, which is equal to 0. This is applicable for infinitely small element fixed in a space. Next is a differential form for non-conservative equation, that is d rho by dt plus rho del into u, which is equal to 0. This is applicable for infinitely small fluid element of a fluid mass moving with the flow. Next comes the rate of change of a fluid particle. Here the fluid element is a volume which is stationary in space, and the fluid particle is a volume of fluid moving with the flow. Here it experiences two rate of changes. One is the changes of a fluid is depends only on the function of time. Next, the changes is due to the fact that is moves to a different location in a fluid which with different conditions. So summing up these two rate of changes for a property per unit mass phi is called the total or substantial derivative d phi by dt. So that our expression will be like this: d phi by dt, which is equal to dou phi by dou t plus dou phi by dou x dx by dt plus dou phi by dou y dy by dt plus dou phi by dou z dz by dt. So for dx by dt, dy by dt and dz by dt, we are going to substitute as u, v, w, so that your equation changes as d phi by dt, which is equal to dou phi by dt plus u into gradient phi. Next, rate of change for a stationary fluid element. In most cases, we change a flow property for a fluid element, that is a stationary in space, so that some equations are easier derived for fluid particles. For a moving fluid particle, the total derivative per unit volume of this property phi is given by rho d phi by dt, which is equal to rho of dou phi by dou t plus u into gradient phi. This equation is for moving fluid particle, and it is this equation location is in space. For a fluid element, for an arbitrary conserved property phi, your equation will be dou rho phi by dou t plus dy rho phi u, which is equal to 0, that you can see in the right hand side of the equation. Next comes, we are going to find the fluid particle and fluid element in terms of Lagrangian and Eulerian. Dou rho phi by dou t plus dy rho phi u, which is equal to rho of dou phi by dou t plus u gradient phi plus phi of dou rho by dou t plus dy rho u, which is equal to rho of d phi by dt. Altogether, summing up all those equations which what we found before, by writing all those these equations here, this phi of dou rho by dou t plus dy rho u, this term becomes 0 because of the continuity. So remaining, except that term, remaining altogether, if we write, we will be getting a continuity equation. Next comes the relevant entries of phi, that is for x, y, z and for energy, altogether how the variable changes. For x momentum, the direction is u, the velocity is u. So its variable as rho du by dt, the expression as dou of rho u by dou t plus dy of rho u. Similarly, we will be writing for y and z, and for energy, your notation is E and the variable as rho de by dt, that is the derivative, and the expression will be dou of rho e by dou t plus dy rho e u. Thank you.